In the last segment, we saw how vectors can be multiplied to give a scalar value, which was known as the dot product. In this segment, we are going to consider how vectors can be multiplied to give a vector with what is known as the cross product. The cross product is denoted, not surprisingly, with a cross, and so it's written as A cross B. And the idea of the cross product is the area of the parallelogram spanned by A and B. So it is really given by the area of this parallelogram spanned by A and B. And therefore, instead of cosine phi, it involves a factor of sine phi. The magnitude is given by the magnitude of A, magnitude of B, and instead of the cosine and the dot product, the sine of phi. But the cross product also has a vector direction, which is given by the right-hand rule. And again, the idea is the same. You curl it from the vector A to the vector B, and you're curling your hand from the vector A to the vector B. And it's where your thumb points. That is where the direction of the cross product is. An interesting point is that the way in A and B, in which order they come, matters, unlike for the dot product. So if I were to do B cross A, I would have to take my thumb, my hand pointed at B, curl it around to the vector A, and now my thumb would be pointing down. So it would be pointing in the opposite direction as A cross B. Therefore, we have this negative formula. They are not commutative. A cross B is equal to minus B cross A. But the very interesting point is that the cross product is orthogonal to both of the initial vectors, and therefore it is very useful in creating a coordinate system, which we'll talk about in a later segment. You can visualize the x, y, and z axes, and by using the right-hand rule, you can yourself verify that these formulae are true. The x cross y is equal to z, y cross z is equal to x, and z cross x is equal to y. It's easy to memorize this by just thinking about the sequence x, y, and z, and cyclically if you go around it. So x cross y will be z, y cross z will be x, and z cross x will be y. If you flip the order, you negate the signs. Here are some properties of the cross product, which you can consider here. A cross B is equal to minus B cross A. Cross product of a vector with itself, because the sign is 0, is 0. We have associativity. A cross B plus C is equal to A cross B plus A cross C. And scaling a vector by a scalar scales the whole cross product. Those are the basic properties of the cross product. The formula for the cross product can be derived. So when we derive the formula, what we want to do is consider a vector which is given by xA times x plus yA times y plus zA times z. And now we want to take the cross product of this vector, so I'll just write this as a cross product, with the same thing. So we have xB, yB, and zb. And so we can consider the vectors x, y, and z. Okay, so now if you take the cross product, because of associativity, you can consider all of the different 9 terms in the cross product. But let's consider some possibilities. So if you consider x cross x, but you know that x cross x is equal to 0. We know that x cross product with x is going to be equal to 0, as is y cross y and z cross z. That's because any vector cross product with itself, the sign is equal to 0. So the terms xA, xB, yA, yB, and zA, zB will disappear. Now we can consider the x cross y term, so x cross y here, and I can write that as xA times yB. It involves x cross y, but we know that x cross y is equal to z. And so I write this as the vector z. Equivalently here, we have y cross x. So yaxb, now we have y cross x. And we know that y cross x is equal to minus x cross y. So we can put this as a negative sign. And this is the vector z. So now we have xayb minus yaxb times z. So I can write this down. There are similar kinds of results for x and y, which allows us to create the formula shown here. So a cross b is written in this way in terms of a determinant. So in the determinant, the first value x involves yazb minus zayb. So yazb minus ybza. The next value y involves zaxb minus xazb, zaxb minus xazb, and z involves xayb minus yaxb, so xayb minus yaxb. Normally, determinants are used to evaluate numbers, but in this case, it's a simple way of doing it where you note that the x, y, and z here are vectors. And similarly here, this corresponds to x, this corresponds to y, and the last row corresponds to z. What is even more interesting is that we can write this in terms of a matrix vector multiplication, where a cross b is some matrix times the column vector for the vector b. So the vector b is xb, yb, and zb. And we are writing it with this matrix here. You can verify by matrix vector multiplication that it does in fact work out. This matrix, which has this interesting form of zeros along the diagonals and antisymmetry, so ZA, ZA, but change in signs, is what is known as the dual matrix of the vector A. So given a vector A, we can convert it into this dual matrix A star, which can be used then to compute the cross product with the vector b.